Welcome, everyone. Shabbat Shalom. So it's a pleasure to be here. I'm Rabbi Barry Silver with Cantor Carol Garrett here at Grand Villa in Delray. And what a pleasure it is to be at such a beautiful facility with such wonderful people who have welcomed us into their home. We're also here with Sharon Leibovitz, who is the MC, the master of ceremonies here, who puts all this together. Suzanne Burstein, who does so much to help our congregation. And Madison, the granddaughter of our cantor, who also does technical things. I would describe what she does, but it's beyond my comprehension. I don't quite understand it all, but I know it's very important. And they also told me that I should ask people to turn off their cell phone, because even if it's not ringing, for some reason, the electric energy interferes with our internet transmission. And again, I don't know why, but if you could do that, that would be great, because we are live streaming this service all around the world. People all over cyberspace are hearing this service, and some of them find this a very wonderful cure for insomnia. And so we don't want to interfere with their ability to use this service for a proper purpose, and hopefully you might be inspired by it. Now, some people ask me, Rabbi, why do we need religion? Is it really necessary for us to be religious? I'm a good person. And my answer is, it is absolutely not necessary. You do not need religion, nor do you need art or music or sports or humor or beauty. You could exist without all of these things. But how much nicer life is when we have a framework to put it in, to enjoy each other, to explore a wonderful heritage, to take time to appreciate what we have in time-honored traditions honed over thousands of years that have been designed to bring out the best in us. Could we do this in the same way every year that has been done over and over for thousands of years? We could, but we would never improve. Judaism believes in the improvability of the human spirit. And so at L'Dor Va-Dor, we believe that religion should be allowed to evolve with increasing knowledge and increasing insights, especially through science and reason. We believe this is the best way to bring out the best in us and our tradition. So join with us. Tonight, we're going to approach a very special topic, one which I know everyone here has grappled with. It's the topic of assimilation. How much should we give up of our heritage to become American? And how much should we retain of Judaism in addition to our heritage? That is the issue that we'll grapple with, and Joseph is going to share with us a wonderful response to how to integrate these different aspects of our identity. We're going to begin with the singing of Hevenu Shalom Alechem, which means peace unto you.
Hevenu Shalom Alechem, Hevenu Shalom Alechem, Hevenu Shalom Alechem, Hevenu Shalom, Shalom, Shalom Alechem, Hevenu Shalom Alechem, Hevenu Shalom Alechem, Hevenu Shalom Alechem, Hevenu Shalom, Shalom, Shalom Alechem.
We believe in Judaism that we were called upon to be a light to the nations. This is symbolized by the lighting of the Shabbat candles, which will be led for us this evening by Helen Daniel. As she comes up, you notice that we have two candles. One symbolizes the light of reason, and the other the light of love, science and religion together. Good Shabbos, and if you'd like to share any comments with us, feel free to do so.
It's just a pleasure to be here, and I hope it could be
in this area for many, many months to come. Take the light to make another light. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kedushonu b'mitzvot sof v'tzivonu lahakdik ner shel Shabbos.
Amen.
Shabbat shalom, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for brightening up our service, Helen. Come, let us welcome Shabbat and give thanks for its light. May our homes shine with the lights of Shabbat, and our hearts glow with Shabbat joy this week and every week. We welcome Shabbat and give thanks for its light. May we be blessed with Shabbat joy and Shabbat peace as we light these Sabbath candles this evening. Now we continue with the Kiddush led for us by Bert Scholl and Miles Hoyt.
Wine symbolizes the power of people to be joyful together. We find grapes in nature and we grow them in vineyards and squeeze them into juice and ferment the juice into wine. We find ourselves in families, in communities, in friendships, in partnerships, and part of a community. It is our creativity and our efforts that make our lives that much sweeter. We therefore raise this cup of sweet wine and recite the words of the Kiddush. Well, Miles will recite the words.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kedishanu b'mitzvotav v'tivanu. Pray for your coffin.
You're allowed to make mistakes.
Do you want to say anything?
I have a bar mitzvah in 3 weeks. Yeah, thank you.
May I say a few words? I want to wish everybody a happy and healthy secular new year. And maybe it's very auspicious, but there's a beautiful full moon shining out there tonight. And I'm hoping that will augur in a good year for all of us. And I want to tell you how proud I am to be standing here with my grandson. I am quelling for the honor of being here together with him tonight.
Well, if you just stay here for a minute, we're all quelling with you because this is going to be a wonderful occasion. We are going to celebrate the first bar mitzvah here at Grand Villa. And I don't know how long, but it's probably been a long time. It's going to be January 27, is that right? January 27, and everyone is invited. We are even bringing in extra chairs and extra food for this occasion. And we're thrilled to have Miles here. And I'm glad that he made a slight faux pas, because at the bar mitzvah, you're going to always expect that it's not going to go exactly as planned. And if you can get ready for that now, that's how life is. It's not always going to go as planned, but you don't worry about it. You just keep moving forward. Did a great job tonight. Thank you for being with us. Bert, thank you. And we'll look forward to seeing you in a few weeks under the expert tutelage of Cantor Carol Garrett. Now we're going to continue with our service with sweet Sabbath wine. When life began, sometime before all knowing, It's growing strong inside of me. Come take my hand, join me in where I'm going. Together we'll find our destiny. Thank you very much to Neil Diamond, and thank you for this wonderful choir we have. Guys did a great job. Now we're going to have a special blessing for all of those who are celebrating birthdays and anniversaries. Please come forward if you would like to make your presence known for a special blessing.
Anytime in January. It doesn't have to be tonight.
Any day in January. Come on up.
Please come up. January birthdays.
My come birthday on up right here.
My birthday was 2 days ago.
Happy birthday.
Congratulations.
Rabbi, direct them where you
get an extra piece of challah. Yeah, stand about right here. Turn and face this way. Or do you want to, you want them to move over here so in front of the camera? Stand in front of the podium if you would. Stand, yeah, move towards the podium. That way everybody
Yay.
Can see you.
Happy birthday, all of you.
Happy birthday, happy anniversary, congratulations. We're going to sing what's called the Birkat Kohanim, the priestly benediction. Take it away.
Yiverecha Adonai
v'yismarecha. May you be blessed and preserved with good health. Que Dios te bendiga y le protege con buena salud.
Ya'er Adonai p'nav elecha v'kunecha.
May the light of love shine upon you always. Que la luz de amor y razón se brille sobre ustedes.
Ya'er Adonai p'nav elecha v'yasem lecha shalom.
May you be lifted up by the power of all the love in this room. Que se levante por el amor este cuarto. And may you be a source of peace for all in this coming year. que ustedes sean una fuente de paz durante todo el año. Felicidades. Mazel tov. Congratulations.
Congratulations. Thank you so much. Simen tov, mazel tov, mazel tov, simen tov. Simen tov, mazel tov, mazel tov, simen tov. Simen tov, mazel tov, mazel tov, simen tov. Yehelanu. Simen tov, mazel tov, mazel tov, simen tov. Simen tov, mazel tov, mazel tov, simen tov. Simen tov, mazel tov, mazel tov, simen tov. Yehelanu.
My friends, we are here to celebrate a very exciting approach to Judaism, one which takes matters into our own hands. And so we're going to enter into some moments of prayer. For us, prayer is not seeking divine intervention from a supernatural entity. For us, prayer is recognizing that we have super and natural qualities within us that are able to transform our lives and transform this world. Our ancestors had an inkling of it, and they shared their hopes and dreams with us. So come join with us as we commune with them and transport ourselves back to their days and throughout history. And we join with the Jewish people throughout the ages, throughout the world, in order to envision a better world and to form a picture of how we can be instrumental in making that day closer that was dreamed of by our prophets. And so we have a series of prayers that are calling upon us to reach those high ideals. We begin reading responsively. We offer thanks for this Shabbat, which unites us in faith and hope.
For Shabbat holiness, which inspires sacred living.
For Shabbat memories glowing even in darkness.
For Shabbat peace, born of friendship and love.
We offer thanks and blessing. Lecha Dodi.
Lecha dodi likrat kalah, b'nei Shabbat nekabela. Lecha dodi likrat kalah, b'nei Shabbat nekabela. Lecha dodi, lecha dodi likrat kalah, b'nei Shabbat nekabela. Lecha dodi likrat kalah. B'nei Shabbat nekabela, likrat Shabbat lechu v'nelcha, ki mekor habracha, meirosh mekedem nesucha, sof maaseh b'malach tikla. Lecha dodi, lecha dodi likrat kala, b'nei Shabbat nekabela. Lecha dodi likrat kala, b'nei Shabbat nekabela. Now, if you'd like to rise and face the doorway, our entrance, and welcome the Sabbath bride. Boi v'shalom ateret bala, gam b'simcha u'zohola, tochem menu'am zigula. Boi kala, boi kala. You may turn around. Lecha dodi, lecha dodi likrat kala, b'nei Shabbat nekabela. Lecha dodi likrat kala, b'nei Shabbat nekabela.
Bevarachu.
You want to remain standing for the Baruch Hu? Baruch Hu Ed Adonai HaMevorach. Baruch Adonai HaMevorach Le'olam Vaed.
Let us exalt and celebrate the wonder, beauty, and majesty of the creative power that gave rise to everything, including us, the Shema.
Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad, Baruch Shem Kevod. Le
Le'olam Va'ed.
Please be seated. I have been asked to read the Hebrew just a little more slowly so people can follow along if they like. We're going to be reading the V'ahavta. Hebrew is a very economic language. V'ahavta means, and you shall love. Four words in English, one in Hebrew. V means and, ahav is love, ta is you, and at the end it means a future tense, V'ahavta. Basically what the prayer is saying is that we should approach everything and everyone with a spirit of love. V'ahavta et Adonai Elohecha, v'chol levavacha, v'chol nafshecha, v'chol modecha. We should love with all our heart, with all our soul, and our strength, modecha. V'hayu hadavarim ha'ele, asher anochi mitzavacha hayom al levavecha, v'shinantam levanecha, v'dibarta bam, v'shivtecha v'beitecha, uvlechtecha v'derech, uvshachpecha uvkumecha, ukshartam lo'ot al yadecha, v'hayu letotafot bein einecha, uchtavtam al mezuzot beitecha, uvyishareha, lema'an tizkahu v'asitem, et kol mitzvotai, v'yitem kidoshim le'elohechem, ani Adonai Elohechem, asher hotzeti etchem me'eretz Mitzrayim, lihiyot lachem le'elohim, ani Adonai Elohechem. The last part says that God brought us out of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. Mitzrayim comes from geographical terminology, means straits, but it also means narrowness. And so what it means is that if we listen to this creative power within us, it liberates us from narrow-minded thinking, allows us to expand our horizons and to be free. Most people are content living the same way every single day, year after year, decade after decade. Shabbat is telling us, be free. Take advantage of the potential within you. You don't have to be tomorrow the person you are today. That's what it means to be liberated from the land of narrowness. Very grateful for the opportunity to share a little bit of our heritage that I picked up from my dad along the way. And I'll also share with you that for the first time in 4 months, I went out on the tennis court and I played some tennis with my son, Ari. Yeah. Now you might think that that's not a big deal, but tennis is a biblical sport. First mentioned in the book of Genesis when it said that Joseph served in Pharaoh's court. That was the first reference to tennis. I remember teaching Ari how to play. I had to take it easy on him. And today he went out and he took it easy on me. But I don't know if you had the opportunity to go outside today, but it was a spectacular, awesome day. It was a beautiful day. And I'm just very, very grateful for having kids, a family, a dog, a wife, beautiful friends at Cantor, and wonderful people here to share Shabbat with. And I thank you very much for joining us.
And the beautiful moon out there.
And the beautiful moon. Do you know that we're kind of a loony people because the Jewish people follow a lunar calendar? And I'm not sure if you realize the significance of the moon. Not only does it track the it tracks the female women's cycle, but it also stabilizes Earth's orbit. Without the moon, we'd be very wobbly and unstable. And it's said that our Jewish tradition also helps to stabilize our life on Earth. That's why we follow the lunar calendar. So yes, we're very grateful for the moon as well. And we're also grateful for Ahava, or amor, or love.
Let there be love and understanding among us. Let peace and friendship be our shelter from life's storms. Let there be love and understanding
shelter from life's storms. Come do that. Hashkivenu Adonai Eloheinu. Hashkivenu L'shalom. Let there be love and understanding among us. Let peace and friendship be a shelter from life's storm. V'hamideinu shomreinu l'chaim. Ufros aleinu sukkat shlomecha. Hashkivenu Adonai Eloheinu. Hashkivenu l'shalom. Let there be love and understanding among us. Let peace and friendship be a shelter from life's storms.
Today, we stand in solidarity with the women in Iran who are struggling and fighting just for the bare minimal essentials of human rights. We stand with them. And we recognize that in Judaism, we weren't always ahead of the curve, but because we've evolved, because we've grown, we now recognize the folly of treating any group of people because of their gender or their sexual orientation or their race in some inferior way. And so we've expanded the prayer that was traditionally called the Avot. It's no longer the Avot. It's the Avot V'Imahot. We give thanks to our Jewish ancestors, men and women, young people and old, who gave us our heritage. As we listen to the Avot V'Imahot and the Givurot, the heroes, may we find ourselves worthy of this blessed heritage and be effective transmitters of its beauty and of its ability to transform the world. The Avot, the Imahot, and the Givurot.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Velohei Avotenu V'Imotenu Elohei Abraham Elohei Yitzchak Elohei Yaakov Elohei Sarah Elohei Rivka Elohei Leah Elohei Rachel Ha'el Hagadol Hagibor Hanora El Elyon Gomer Chasadim Tovim V'Konei Hakol V'Zocher Chasdei Avot V'Imahot Umevi gula liv nevenehem, leman shemo be'ahava, melech ozer umoshia umagen. Baruch atah Adonai, magen Avraham, ve'atzrat Sarah. Atah gibor le'olam Adonai, mechaye hako atah rav lehoshia. Mechachel chayim v'chesed, mechayim etem v'rakabim rabim, tomech noflim v'rochek oholim, umatir asurim, umekayim emunato, lishene afar, mifamocha ba'al givurot, umidomelach, Melech Meir Umechaye Umatzmiak Yeshua Benemanata Lechayot Hakol Baruch Atah Adonai Mechaye Hakol.
Please be seated. We started out with Avinu Shalom Aleichem, a song of peace. And now we have another peace song, Shalom Rav. That is because on Shabbat, peace is our constant theme. It runs right throughout our whole Shabbat celebration. Shalom Rav.
Shalom Rav, Bal Yisrael Amcha, Tashim Leolam. Shalom Rav, Bal Yisrael Amcha, Tashim Leolam. Shalom Rav, Al Yisrael Amcha, Tashim Leolam. Shalom Rav, Al Yisrael Amcha, Tashim Leolam. Ki Atahu Melech Adon Lecho HaShalom, Ki Atahu Melech Adon Lecho HaShalom. Shalom Rav, Al Yisrael Amcha, Tashim Leolam. Shalom Rav, Al Yisrael Amcha, Tashim Leolam. V'tov b'enecha livarech Et Amcha Yisrael Bechol Eir v'kol Shah Bishlomecha. Shalom Rav, Al Yisrael Amcha, Tashim Leolam. Shalom Rav, Al Yisrael Amcha, Tashim Leolam. Tashim Leolam. Tashim Leolam.
Many people believe that peace is something that if you just do nothing, it'll descend upon us. Sadly, we know this is not the case. The Hebrew word for peace, shalom, is related to the word shalem, which means to pay. It also means fulfillment. It means that in order to achieve peace, sometimes we have to pay a heavy price. Sometimes there are obligations that we have to fulfill in order to achieve peace. In World War II, there were people in the United States who said we should stay out. We should not get involved. We're only dragged into it when we were attacked. If we had never fought back, there would have been no peace, and there would have been no Jews. We sadly know from history that sometimes peace is paid for with a very heavy price. And so it is that tonight we remember 2 years ago that there was an insurrection attempted against our government and against our country. And some very, very brave people fought back against insurmountable almost odds, very difficult odds. And some of them paid the ultimate price. And they fought valiantly to protect us. And on this anniversary, we know that the struggle is not over. We must continue to fight to establish peace, to maintain democracy, and to keep our country and our liberties safe. With this in mind, with gratitude for the heroism of people throughout the ages who have fought so that we could be free, we enter into a few moments of silent meditation. And let us perhaps ponder what we can do in order to bring about a more peaceful world. Amen. We now enter silent meditation. Thank you. The silence that we embark upon should be broken during the week. We should end our silence and work hard for peace. And we should continue to meditate throughout the week on how we can bring out a more peaceful world. We're now going to read the names of those who are ailing at this time. Michelle Bernstein, Laura Gallagher, Sherry Glass, Nadine Herbst, Stephen Heyman, Carol Kahn, Howard Mandel, Dr. Sudhir Nair, Ira Phillips, Libby Rubin, Laura Santa Cruz, Brett Schwartz, Harvey Shearer, Dee Silverman, Fred Spieloff, Douglas Volan, Jordan Volan, and Sheila Winston. Any other names that anybody would like to add? Yes? Yes? Anybody else?
Ann Kritzer, Audrey Katz.
Anyone else? We think of all of those who are ailing, including Damar Hamlin, who's injured playing football, and we hope that they might all receive a refuah shlema, complete restoration to good health.
May the source of strength who bless the ones before us help us find the courage to make our lives a blessing and let us say Amen. Mishabach imotinu mekor habracha le'avotinu. Bless those in need of healing with refuah shlema, the renewal of body, the renewal of spirit, and let us say Amen.
Now it's time for us to wish a Shabbat Shalom to our neighbors. We're now going to have the Torah reading. Before we do that, we engage in responsive reading. Please join with me. Torah is a closed book until it is read with an open heart.
House of Israel, great and small, open your hearts to the words of Torah.
Torah is demanding, yet sweeter than honey, more precious than gold.
House of Israel, young and old, open yourselves, heart and soul, to its treasures.
Im tirtzu, if you will it, it's no dream.
Agada, angel Agada, Liot Akoshi, Beratainu, Beeret Zion, Berushalayim, Tetsu, Im Tetsu, angel Agada, angel Agada, Liot Akoshi, Beratainu, Be'eret Zion, Berushalayim.
Baruch Hu Et Adonai Hamavarach.
Baruch Adonai Hamavarach Le'olam Vaed.
Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Asher Bachar Banu Mikol Hamim, Ve'natan Lanu Et Torato. Baruch atah Adonai, Noten HaTorah.
The blessing before the Torah gives thanks for having us be the chosen people who were receiving this wonderful Torah. Modern Jews interpret it differently. We don't believe that a divine power chose us. We believe that our ancestors did the choosing, more to their credit. They chose to adopt a moral law. They chose to follow this law. They chose to try to be a source of blessing. And each day, when we listen to this passage, we get to choose. Will we be part of that effort to bring about enlightenment? Will we just passively listen and then walk out and maybe have a piece of challah? Or will we listen to these words and choose to be part of this exciting enterprise of joining with a group of people over thousands of years to make this world a better place? Vayal Yosef le'Ephraim b'nei Shloshim, gam b'nei Machir ben Menashe, yildu al b'yokei Yosef. Joseph contemplated the fact that Ephraim, the son of the third generation of his, also the son of Machir, the son of Menashe, was seated upon his knee. Vayomer Yosef elchav. Joseph said to his brothers, Anochi met ve'Elohim pakad yifkod etchem ve'elita etchem min ha'aretz hazot el eretz asher nishba l'Avraham l'Yitzhak l'Yaakov. I am going to die soon, and I shall die here in Egypt, but God is going to take you to the land that he promised to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Ve'yishba Yosef b'nei Yisrael l'mor. And Joseph made his brethren, the children of Israel, promise to him, Pakod yifkod Elohim etchem behalitim et atzmotai. When God takes you out of this land and brings you to the land that he swore to our ancestors, take my bones with you. The word for bone is atzmotai. V'yamat Yosef ben mea ve'eser. And Joseph died at the age of 110. V'yachantu oto v'yasem ba'aron b'mitzrayim. He died at 110. They embalmed him, and they placed him in an ark or in a coffin in Egypt. I must share with you, these are the last words of the Torah, are the last words of this section of the Torah, the last words of the first book of the Torah, Bereshit. And so we say, which means may we be strengthened, may our people be strengthened by the reading of the Torah. And I do want to share with you just a few words from the very end that have been interpreted in a very fascinating way. Joseph says that he wants the people to bring atzmotai, my bones, up to the promised land. But his body was placed in a coffin in Egypt. It's been interpreted to mean that his physical body was no more, and so it remained in a coffin in Egypt. But atzmotai, meaning bones, also means the essence. In Hebrew, modern Hebrew, if you want to say, I want to do it myself, ani rotze la'asot et atzmi. Atzmi means myself. Atzmotai is my essence. Yes, my body, which doesn't do me any good after I die, that can stay here in a coffin. It could be dead and buried in Egypt. But my essence, my love for my people, my idealism, let that live on. Let that be brought up to the promised land. And that promised land could be anywhere. It could be Israel, it could be America, or it could be the sanctuary of our heart. Let my essence remain with the Jewish people forever. We continue now with the blessing after the Torah. If you'd like, please join with me. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher natan lanu Torat emet v'chayei olam nata bitochenu. Baruch atah Adonai noten haTorah. Amen. Now, Joseph had to grapple with something that was very tricky, and Jews have been dealing with this for a very long time. He was uprooted from his native land, involuntarily sold into slavery, and he found himself in Egypt. When he got to Egypt, he did something that some people might consider very wrong. He took on an Egyptian name. He took on an Egyptian wife. He named his children with Egyptian names. He became what we call, what has become a dirty word to some people, assimilated. He assimilated into Egyptian culture. And this has been condemned by Jewish people for centuries, for millennia. Assimilation is considered one of the worst sins of the Jewish people. It reminds us of the person who has joined a golf club and tried to hide the fact that he was Jewish. They said, are you Jewish? Me? No. I'm not Jewish. And my father wasn't Jewish. And my grandfather, Alav Shalom, he wasn't Jewish either. Also reminds me of the story about the guy who's playing golf at the club, trying to hide his identity. It's a horrible shot. And he says, oy vey Izmir. And then he looks around and he goes, whatever that means. My friends, many Jewish people have tried to find a way to integrate into society and hide their Jewish identity. Others have shunned the outside world. You can see them, even in America. They want nothing to do with America and its customs and its ways. They still live a completely Jewish life, the same way they might be living back in Poland. What are we supposed to do? How are we supposed to grapple with this? We're in the United States. We're Americans, and are we Jews? Are we Americans first? Are we Jews first? Can we be both? Joseph leads the way. Many Jewish people take on American-sounding names. Balfour Brickner was a great, great rabbi. Albert Einstein is a great Jewish leader. I mean, many Jewish people take on the names of their culture. So that really is not a major impediment. Many Jewish people adopt Western dress. Most of us dress like Americans, except maybe for a rabbi on Shabbat. Of course, I wear the tallit with the fringe to show that we never hesitate to stand on the fringe of society when necessary to oppose bullies and tyrants and to stand up for what's right. What is it that Joseph was able to do? He used his Yiddish cup. He used his Jewish mind in order to become part of Egypt, but also separate and apart from Egypt to save Egypt. He used his talents, his ingenuity, his foresight, and his belief in powers that were beyond him in order to save all of Egypt. And in return, he saved his own people as well. He was not only for his own people, and he was not only for Egypt. He was bigger than all that. He was international, cosmopolitan. He was able to save all of Egypt and his people. But more than that, he asked his brothers, when he made himself known to them, does my father still live? And he showed that despite his change of name and his status and his integration into Egyptian society, his father, his Jewish roots, his Yiddish neshama still lived, because he showed compassion for his brothers. What would most leaders have done? You sold me into slavery, and now you come groveling before me? The heck with you. Off with their head. He didn't just provide for them. He didn't just begrudgingly take care of them because of his family. The Torah says, he spoke to their heart. He told a white lie. He said, it wasn't your fault what you did. That was part of a divine plan. Don't beat yourself up over that. It all turned out for the best. Did he really believe it? Who knows? But one thing we do know, he was 100% Jewish at that point. Despite the outer trappings, his neshama, his soul was Jewish. His etzem, his atzmutai, was always with the Jewish people. He identified with them. Many of us have difficulty doing that. We're so enthralled by American culture. My friends, American culture is Jewish culture. The words on the Liberty Bell are from the book of Leviticus. The words of the Statue of Liberty were written by Emma Lazarus, a Jew. The motto of the United States of America, seeking freedom from oppression, is Moses seeking freedom. You don't have to choose one or the other, but I'll tell you this much. If the United States ever becomes a melting pot,
And if the Jewish people were to be melted or dissolved into the general population, that would be a tremendous loss, a horrible loss, not only for the Jewish people, but for the United States of America. Because if this country ever became a melting pot, as some people would like, and the Jewish people lost its identity, who would be able to stand up and fight for what's right? Who would be there to challenge authority? Who would be a thorn in the side to would-be tyrants? Who would be able to share the indomitable spirit of the Jew who believes that all of us are created in a divine image and that our goal and our destiny is to create a better world instead of getting lost in cynicism? Who would do that? We're not a melting pot. We are more like a stew. And we are part of that stew, and we have the recipe for a better world. Jewish values and American ideals, Rachmanis, kindness, compassion, chesed, righteousness, shalom, peace, and ideals that are very often overlooked, especially today. Emet, truth. How many people do you know who say there's no such thing as truth? It's all subjective. Your truth, my truth, our truth. We Jews don't believe that. We believe that there's an ultimate truth. Our ancestors started with some kind of being. It's not a being. There are physical laws. There are truths that make this world go round. And love is one of them. That without love, the world is empty. And it's barren. And it's desolate. We Jews believe in love. We say v'ahavta. And so, my friends, we believe that we are not a melting pot, we are a stew. And not only that, we Jews are stewards. We're stewards of morality. We must be stewards of this planet. Many people think the earth is here to be exploited. There are many people who think that the United States is best symbolized by the dollar sign, which is actually a U and an S, U-S, with the bottom pulled out. They think that America stands for money, and that the more money you have, the more American you are. And the more you exploit the world, the better you are. My friends, that's a fool's errand. We Jews, every Shabbat, celebrate creation. And if we don't share an appreciation with creation, with the world, there is no hope. Do you know that they're coming up with technology that's going to be able to feed 10 billion people? Probably by the year 2050. If the population doubles every 25 years, will that be good enough? Where will people live? Where will they get water? Where will they have resources? We need to understand Emet Vatzedek, the Emet of Malthus, who said we must deal with our population. Population and resources are not unlimited. Be fruitful and multiply made sense with two people, with 7 billion. We need to cherish life. And the way to cherish life is not to force women against their will to become parents when they're not ready. To cherish life means to empower women, empower families, and to allow Jewish values to prevail, which really understands the sanctity of life. I hope we'll learn the lesson from Joseph. Joseph was someone who navigated so well the ability to assimilate into modern society and never forget our Jewish roots. Because the world needs us to be Jews. And if we shirk jury duty, J-E-W-R-Y, this world is going to be in sorry shame. So let us remember and be proud of our Jewish heritage, not just to resist anti-Semitism, but to proudly go forth and to share the values and the ideals that this world urgently needs from our wonderful Jewish heritage, as Joseph did so well. Shabbat Shalom. And now we continue with Hashkivenu, right?
I think that you're right. Yes.
Sorry.
This song, it says Rabbi's original. I didn't actually make up the Hashkivane. Hashkivane is pretty darn old. The English lyrics that kind of match it, I did create that. And I appreciate being able to sing it with Cantor Garrett. And I will tell you that one of the most beautiful videos I've seen was created by Cantor Jennifer Werby, who took this song and sang it and created a music video. And the video that goes along with it is quite spectacular. I think it's on our website. If not, it's on our YouTube channel. Check it out, and you'll see some other really awesome music from Cantor Garrett and from others. And if you stay on that YouTube channel, you'll find new and more innovative songs and discussions all the time. We now continue with the Aleinu V'ne'emar.
Please rise if you're able, in body or spirit.
Aleinu L'shabbeach L'Adon HaKol L'atek Gedula Yotze Bereshit Shelo Asanu K'goye HaRatzot Velo Shamanu K'mishpichot Hadama Shelo Sam Kelkenu Kahem Vegoralenu Keko Amonam Ve'anachnu Korim Umishtachavim Umodim Lifne Melech Malchei Hamlachim HaKadosh Baruch Hu V'ne'emar V'haya Adonai L'melech HaKoharet
Bayom Hahu, Bayom Hahu, Ye Adonai Esad, Ushemo, Ushemo, Ushemo Echad.
Please remain standing for the Kaddish. We read the names of those who have recently been summoned from us: Estelle Goodman, Louis Greenberg, Natalie Kappel, Eileen Levine, Hilda Nadelberg, Pele, Doris Pollack, Linda Pruskin, Herbert Radak, Barbara Walters,
Carol Maddox,
and also those the anniversary of whose departure occurs these days: George Bernstein, Marcia Bernstein, Dr. Samuel Brown, Kurt Daniel, Herbert Dressler, Blanche Ferdin, Louis Friedman, Carl Goldman, Morris Goldsmith, Robert Grosky, Harry Hauptman, Abraham Honig, Maurice Hyman, Bertha Jandorf, Mishka Jett, Francis Kaufman, Philip Leaf, Trudy Malin, Lillian Martin, Sally Perlman, Paul Duke Richard, Susan Rimsky, Ileona Spruckman, Rita Vulcan Diaz, Larry Wexler, Shirley Winkler, and Francis R. Wood. Any other names you'd like to add? We hope that their memory will be for a blessing and that their wonderful qualities will live on through us as we read the Kaddish together.
She doesn't have it on there, but you can read it right here.
Yiskadal, Yiskadash Shemir Abba, Biyama Divrach Ruse, Viamlich Mahuse, Bahayahon, Viamehon, Bahaye, the whole base Israel, Bahagalab is man Kari, Vimru Amen.
Amen.
Yehe Shemir Abba, Mibarach, Olam, Omeo Maya, Yisparach, Yistabach, Yispoar, Yiskoman, Yisnase, Yisadar, Yisalev, Yisalah, Shemir, Kirisha, Birichu. Le'elom in kol b'chasa v'shirasa, tush b'chasa v'nechamasa, dam yohon v'yoma v'yimru amen.
Amen.
Yehe shlama rabba min shmaya v'chayim, aleinu v'yokol Yisrael v'yimru amen. Ose shalom v'yimru mav, v'yase shalom aleinu v'yokol Yisrael v'yimru amen. Please be seated. Before the announcements, I just want to share with you a final word. You can call this in the spirit of a benediction. It was in 1907 that a young Jewish man graduated from Yale Law School. And when he graduated from Yale Law School, he was very proud. And he's the only one in the history of Yale who said, "I want my diploma translated into Hebrew, because Hebrew is the language that inspired our founding fathers. Hebrew is a language which is on the insignia of Yale, and Hebrew is my language." And they granted him that request, and his name was Joseph. His name was Joseph George Shapiro. That's my grandfather. He has the only diploma ever translated into Hebrew. He reflected Joseph, who was every bit as American as he could possibly be, going to Yale Law School. He was on the admissions to Connecticut Bar. In fact, when I became an attorney and I had very long hair, he said, "With your hair that long, if you ever appeared in front of me, I would never admit you to practice law in the state of Connecticut." He still maintained his sense of humor. And he raised a daughter who was able to incorporate the best of American traditions and went to Juilliard and also retained her Judaism and became the choir director and the musical director and the leader of this congregation. My grandfather sets a very good example of being proud of America and being proud of our Jewish tradition. I'll leave this here if you'd like to see. You can see on the bottom it says Hanasi, the president, and this is Makil HaUniversita, the secretary of the University of Yale Law School. And now we have announcements from Sharon Leibovitz.
Thank you, Rabbi Barry. That was amazing. Thank you for a great service, a beautiful sermon. Thank you, Cantor Carol. Thank you, Jennifer, Cantor Jennifer. Thank you, Madison.
And thanks everyone for coming. Shabbat Shalom, Happy New Year, happy and healthy. Tomorrow we have something brand new and special here, live in person at 10 a.m., current events with Rabbi Barry. So if you'd like to be here tomorrow again at 10 a.m., I think he's going to be doing it every week. We're not sure yet, so be advised whether it's going to be monthly or weekly. But tomorrow they're doing current events. On Tuesday evening, January 10th, Touch of Torah, an inspirational view of Torah, and with Rabbi Barry on Zoom at 7 p.m. each Tuesday evening. Next Friday, January 13th, join us here at 7:30 for our next Shabbat. And next Sunday, January 15th, at 11 a.m., our men's club meet for breakfast at the Bagel's End at Hypoluxo and Jog. And our ladies meet on the same day at 1:30 p.m., our Sisterhood Ladies Luncheon at Terra Fiamma in Delray Marketplace. So if you can attend, everyone's welcome, and we welcome everyone to L'Dor Va-Dor. Thank you so much. Please see us on our website, ldorvador.org, our Facebook page, our YouTube channel, and our Instagram account. And please be with us here live or virtually each Shabbat at 7:30. Thank you so much. And I turn it back over to Rabbi Barry for the final benediction.
Thank you. I will let you in on the inside scoop as far as how I got to be selected to do the current events. It was a very difficult process. They had a bunch of names and they picked, and even though I'm rather controversial, my name came out as the top vote getter. They decided to try it again. So they had another round and they tried and they picked again, and it was my name again. And my name kept coming up about 11 times, and they said, well, if his name keeps coming up 11, 12, 13 times, I guess we're stuck with the guy, and we'll give it a shot. It will be kind of interesting. I'm the only rabbi to have served in the Florida legislature. I do get a little controversial sometimes, and there will be some interesting discussions that we will have. I can share this with you. We definitely want to hear all points of view, and I have tried my best to find somebody of a conservative nature to stand with me or sit with me to help lead the discussion. So far, I've been unsuccessful. I encourage you, call up your local Republican club. Call up your Right to Life Club. Call up your local representatives who are Republican. Call people and let's get dialogue going. Let's show that we can disagree agreeably, and let's have intelligent discussion instead of all the nonsense and rancor which passes for dialogue. It's a shame that you can't get two people speaking about issues, but we'll give it a shot. But tomorrow you're stuck with me. I will be here by myself at 10 o'clock. We will hear all points of view, and I look forward to that. We also have the National Organization for Women, their 50th anniversary coming up February 12, which is Lincoln and Darwin's birthday. They saw fit to honor me as the only man to have won that award in 50 years. We're all invited to the luncheon. Tell them that it wasn't a mistake. They don't have to wait another 50 years to find some other guy. And come out and support the luncheon and support now. They're a good group. Also, they did a documentary on me and L'Dor Va-Dor's lawsuit for the abortion case. It's going to be at the Sundance Film Festival, shown later this month. And then that documentary will be made available to all. I plan on traveling out to Salt Lake City, but stay tuned because it's going to be a very interesting documentary. And I also have something in mind. I think we might be taking a weekend cruise on Royal Caribbean. I'm working on that right now. And I will keep you posted on my progress. I happen to have performed wedding ceremonies for some of their officials, and I'm pretty friendly with the folks over at Royal Caribbean. If we can pull that off, I'll let you know. We'll go off on maybe a Shabbat.
I'm there.
All right, we'll go off on a Shabbat celebration, and a cruise should be lots of fun. So with that, I already gave my final benediction, so we're going to move right into the motzi.
Amotzi lechem min haaretz. We give thanks to God for bread. Our voices rise in song together as our joyful prayer is said.
Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, Hamotzi lechem min haaretz. Amen.
And now a third song for peace. We began with peace. We have peace in the middle. And now, Yihyeh Shalom. May there be peace.
When we hear one another, there will be peace in the world. When we understand one another, there will be peace in the world. When we love one another, there will be peace in the world.
Yihyeh Shalom.
Yihyeh Shalom Ba'olam.
Yihyeh Shalom.
Yihyeh Shalom. When we believe in one another, there will be peace in the world. When we learn from one another, there will be peace in the world. When we work with one another, there will be peace in the world. Yihyeh Shalom. Yihyeh Shalom Ba'olam. Yihyeh Shalom. Yihyeh Shalom. When we believe that peace will come, we can see the beauty in everyone. When we believe that peace can be, that we are children of one family. Yihyeh Shalom. Yihyeh Shalom Ba'olam. Yihyeh Shalom. Yihyeh Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.